Melting gold and ingots, the process itself. Gold is a precious metal that has not lost its relevance to this day. And all due to the fact that gold, in addition to external beauty, has unique physical and chemical properties. Chemically speaking, gold does not react with virtually any substance. And physical properties, for example, malleability, resistance, melting point of gold also make it possible to use this metal for almost any need. But the industry does not use gold due to its high cost and relatively small amount in nature. So most of the properties of metal remain unclaimed. Physical properties of gold are evaluated according to the following criteria. Malleability, plastic, hardness, electrical conductivity, resistance, melting temperature. Gold itself is most often used in jewelry. It is there that the precious metal takes on some form and is produced in the form of products. The melting point is of interest not only to jewelers, but also to lovers of experimentation and home smelting of gold. After all, it is possible to melt precious metal, to perform refining, that is purification, and increase in sample at home. But for this, it is necessary to know the melting point of the metal. Pure metal belongs to the group of medium melting ones, which means that the indicator is in the range from 770 to 1603 degrees Celsius. The lowest melting point is 770 degrees Celsius. It is characteristic of the 375 carat gold alloy. That is, pure precious metal in it is only 37.5%. Pure gold melts at 1063 degrees Celsius. The indicator is quite high, but it can be achieved with the help of special furnaces in which the process takes place. Melting occurs because gold atoms are freed from the crystalline bonds in the lattice at the molecular level. And as a result of the disintegration of crystallites, the metal of liquid consistency is formed. Melting gold. There are two main ways to melt metal. Individual method of smelting gold. It consists in the fact that the jeweler at his workplace, with the help of an open burner and a cup for melting metals, melts gold. The flame must be strong enough, and the main task of the jeweler is to follow the safety rules. In this form, precious metal can be poured into molds and an ingot or other products can be made. Centralized type of melting. It consists in the fact that one alloy is made from several alloys of different samples. This procedure is carried out in factories. And then, after re-melting, a sample of the resulting metal is determined, or further purification from impurities and an increase in the sample is carried out. For this, special high-frequency or electric furnaces are used, depending on the volume of gold for melting. It should be remembered that gold smelting ends at the stage when the entire piece of metal is melted, and not just some of it. At home, this can be done with a 585 fineness or lower. But it will be difficult to work with pure gold without special equipment. At the same time, it is better to melt the metal in separate rooms or special laboratories. Sometimes gold from old devices can be used for smelting. Low-grade gold was often used in microcircuits because it has good conductivity, low resistance, and a long service life. Nowadays, gold is used less and less in microcircuits. But if you take apart old televisions and other devices, you can pick up small amounts of gold particles. And in order to be accepted into the pawn shop, it is necessary to fuse these particles. For such a process, knowledge of the melting point, as well as various chemical reagents, will also be needed. You should also select heat-resistant cookware for the melting process. Melting point is one of the important indicators of the physical properties of gold. First of all, it interests people from a practical point of view. If you know all the aspects of doing this work, you can easily melt or melt gold even at home. You should also remember about safety rules during the melting process.